Hello, I'm Wayne from TorqueCars. So in this video, we're going to look at some questions that we've got about turbos. What is a turbo? Why were turbos invented and how do they work? What are blow-off valves? What's a wastegate actuator do? And what are these twin scroll turbos? What's the difference between them and standard turbos? And we're also going to look at the debate as to whether you should have a twin turbo set up in parallel or in series, and whether there's benefits to converting a twin turbo into a large turbo. Stay tuned for answers to all of your turbo questions coming right up. We get asked a lot of questions, so we're just going to do some quick fire sessions, just answering very specific questions. We're not going to go into a great deal of depth on the subject, but our aim is to give an overview of the subject. So what is a turbocharger? Well, a turbocharger is a device that's used for compressing the air that goes into an engine. You want to use a turbocharger because if you can get more air into the engine, it's carrying more oxygen. And when you've got more oxygen, you can burn more fuel, and that equates to more power. Now, they use turbochargers in aeroplanes. At high altitude, the air was much thinner and they needed more power. And they could go higher if they used a turbocharger to compress the thin air up there, and it enabled them to burn more fuel, make more power, and they could go faster and higher. And it dramatically altered the way that aircraft worked. And that technology has boiled down to what we have in cars today. And so many modern cars are now fitted with a turbocharger. It really enhances the efficiency of an engine and allows you to get substantial amounts of power from it. So how does a turbocharger actually work? Well, do you remember those windmills you used to get at the seafront, the stick with the little windmill on it that used to spin round? In a way, a turbocharger is basically two of those connected back to back. So the first little windmill blades, if you like, is connected to the exhaust. So as the exhaust comes out of the engine, it rotates that little turbine, and that's connected to the intake. And as that rotates, it sucks in more air. So you're using the momentum of the exhaust gases to rotate a compressor wheel to suck more air in. Now, the downside of this operation is that at low RPMs, low engine speeds, you don't get very much exhaust flow. And this manifests itself as lag. The turbo just isn't producing very much power at those low RPM figures. Changing the size of the blades in those turbines can have a dramatic effect on the way the power is delivered. It can, for example, spool up more quickly, or it can produce more power at the top end. And there's so many different aspects of technology that have been applied to turbochargers relatively recently. For example, we've got twin scroll turbos. So the twin scroll turbo splits the engine up. So if you have a four cylinder engine, two cylinders go into one part of the turbo and the other two cylinders go into the other part. And this enables better scavenging in the engine. It usually provides a much quicker spool up. Mitsubishi applied for a patent for the twin scroll turbocharger in the end of 2011. And the patent shows the design of the twin chambers within the exhaust, where the exhaust gases are channeled from alternate ports on the engine into very separate chambers. It goes down the inside edge of the twin scroll directly onto the turbine. And because that's a narrower chamber, there's less expansion going on. You're not suffering from the vortices that tend to form, and you get a higher velocity of air coming out, allowing the turbocharger to spool up more quickly, and it tends to make more power. So there's lots of benefits to a twin scroll design, but they're not suitable for all engines. Now, you can compare the turbo's outputs and decide on a turbo that actually suits your application. Some people want the power to be delivered from low down and mid-range, so for everyday driving, you're not that interested in the top-end power. For motorsports and drag racing, you might be in a situation where you want all of the power at the top end and you're not worried at all about the low RPM. So you would get a turbo that's set up and matched to those specific requirements. We've also got turbochargers with variable vane technology. So the angles of those vanes can actually be altered to maximize the amount of rotation you get from any given flow of exhaust. So as you look down into a turbo, you'll basically see these two turbines and how they rotate And that in its simplest form is how a turbo works. But obviously, while a turbo is compressing air, you might have a situation where you lift off the throttle and you've got all this pressurized air in the intake, and you would use a blow-off valve or a diverter valve to take that air pressure and put it somewhere useful rather than just have it build up in the intake. If you've got all that pressure in the intake, it could potentially damage the turbocharger itself. A lot of Volkswagen Audi Group cars, for example, would dump the excess air pressure into the intake, and if you divert it to the atmosphere, you'll end up with error codes and flat running. That's just the way that their ECUs and everything has been set up. But in other cars, you can just vent to the atmosphere and you can have some very creative dump valve noises.
And you can control the speed of the turbo with a wastegate actuator that controls the amount of exhaust gases that are flowing through the turbo. So it's not just a mechanical device that bolts on. There's lots of other components that go along with it, and they help to enhance the power delivery of the turbocharger. Some cars are actually equipped with two turbos. Now, they can be fitted in parallel, so they both come on at the same time, or they can be staged. So one turbo cuts in at low RPMs, and then at a certain point, when there's enough exhaust gases to drive both, the second turbocharger cuts in. And you've got a debate as to whether to replace a twin turbo setup with a large single turbo, or whether you should just keep it as a twin turbocharger and maybe get a more modern design turbo that delivers the power in the stages that you want. You could also vary the size of the turbos and have a smaller turbo to start off and then switch the power to a larger turbocharger. There really is an endless combination. So we'd encourage everyone thinking about turbocharger upgrades to sit down, look at the specs, decide where in the RPM range you actually want the power, and to get a turbo that gives you that profile that you actually want and delivers the power where you need it. So we hope this has been informative to you. If you've not subscribed to the channel, please do so. We've got lots of other interesting topics coming up. We're answering a lot more questions, and please don't forget to stay tuned.